There's definitely something in this town. Do you feel it, Zach? My coffee warned me about it.
Deadly Premonition is uncut black tar batshit, and you do yourself an immense disservice by not playing it. Oh sure, the game couldn't be any more low rent without being hired as an IGN female news anchor, but at least the game's $20 price tag reflects this fact. It's not so much a diamond in the rough as a diamond with rough edges. Furthermore, the game absolutely defies explanation, which is why I live in hope that you'll get a nice belly laugh out of watching the following vain attempt at synopsis. So here goes.
Hold on to your butts.
Deadly Premonition is an open-world, forensic, survival horror, third-person shooting sim. If that sounds good, you're fucking wrong. It's goddamn fantastic. And what blows my mind is that even though I've seen cell phone games with a higher development budget than Deadly Premonition, they managed to somehow combine each of these disparate elements into a fascinating, faultless fusion of fuck yeah. Now mind you, I'm using the word faultless purely for alliterative purposes here, because this game is buggier than Hannah Minx's panty liners.
Mina-san, Ohio!
But what needs to work, fucking works. Yeah, sure, if you sit and actually think about certain things, your skull may very well explode with a force of a thousand suns. For example, why is it I was in Greenvale for over a week and only had to eat 5 meals in that entire time? Is Agent York on the Charlize Theron diet? Yes, the sleep, hunger, and stress meters don't serve any practical function, but they achieve the intended effect, which is immersing the player in the world. A bit like Fallout New Vegas' hardcore mode if it had been tested even a single fucking time. The shooting? It works. It won't blow your mind.
Nice shot. Amazing.
But I find it somewhat quizzical that many of the same publications that swore up and down that Resident Evil 4 was the reincarnation of Christ somehow found irredeemable fault in Deadly Premonition's use of essentially the exact same control scheme and functionality. I mean, if I didn't know better, I'd say Game Failures, Kotaku, IGN, GameSpy, GameSpot, 1UP, Joystick, GamePro, Play, PSM, OXM, EGM, Nintendo Power, The Escapist, and PC Gamer were a bunch of sold-out, ignominious advertising revenue whores who assigned scores relative to the monolithic shitloads of ad revenue cash funneled their way in the form of exclusive perks, free gaming rigs, and unsolicited back-alley blowjobs, but we all know that's not the case. Story-wise, the whirling maelstrom of disparate narrative inspirations doesn't so much perfectly congeal as wind up looking like a writhing nude man-pile involving Twin Peaks, Silent Hill, Heavy Rain, Grand Theft Auto, and a suspiciously well-trained orangutan, but at the same time, the story is unfurled at such an intriguing, hypnotic pace that before you finish the first couple acts, you're thoroughly enthralled by the discordant fucking lunacy of it all. Sure, you'll initially scoff at the last-gen graphics, but somehow as the game winds its way from ridiculous plot point to fucking ridiculous plot point, you'll find yourself saying things like, better get back to the hotel before the demonic Jack Russell Terrier materializes at midnight to eat my fucking car without batting a goddamn eyelash. Does it make sense to eat a jelly and breakfast cereal sandwich to advance the fucking plot? Let me answer that question with another question. Does it make sense to stick your entire fucking arm into a backed up toilet to dislodge a wallet you have no reason to believe will have a safe combination scrawled inside of it?
Who would even think of doing something so disgusting?
It's a video game! Fucking deal with it! Whereas in Silent Hill, you usually play as a well-mannered everyman or woman, just trying to make sense of the bizarre surroundings and phallic monster hordes dry-humping every moist orifice in his or her body, in this game, the protagonist is nuttier than bukkake granola. This fucker has an imaginary friend named Zack and is firmly convinced that his morning coffee is a fucking precog.
Did you see that, Zack? Clear as a crisp spring morning. F.K. In the coffee. I knew I could count on it. Never fails.
What are you talking about, Willis?
The soundtrack is a sublime fucking train wreck. Whether you're watching a cutscene of York performing an autopsy with the Andy Griffith theme wailing over top, or you're chatting with Cabal from Mortal Kombat to the ominous rhythms of fucking smooth jazz, it's clear that whatever modern Mozart composed this majestic soundtrack was pretty much handed a guitar, a synthesizer, and a bag of blow and told to fucking go for it. But somehow, it works! Never mind that the game's antagonists are Seamus and this rotund, blubbery fuck.
Hello, Noman.
Never mind that human bones are just lying around in open fields and York shrugs them off because they're unrelated to the case. Wow, is that standard FBI operational procedure? You trip and fall over a corpse, and if it belongs to the wrong person, then oh well, fuck them. Your tax dollars at work, Rageaholics.
Override a guilt by association.
The game's lead designer, Swery, has proclaimed his intention to bring a graphically improved remake of Deadly Premonition to the PlayStation 3 sometime before the end of the year. And on that subject, my feelings are decidedly mixed. To date, Deadly Premonition has been released only on Xbox 360, which means the surprisingly positive word of mouth that led to the surprisingly positive review scores, which led to the surprisingly positive sales, were generated by Xbox 360 gamers who were about to be fucked up the ass and told to buy the PS3 version if they want all the hidden goodies that their enthusiasm for the game allowed Swery to create in the first place. Incidentally, it's the same feeling I had when Mass Effect 2 was ported to the PS3 with over $100 worth of DLC that 360 gamers had to purchase with actual dollars. That's just fucked up no matter which way you slice it. Mass Effect 2 wouldn't have been popular enough to warrant a cross-console port without the same 360 gamers you just lifted the fucking finger at, BioWare. At least launch it in conjunction with a Game of the Year edition on the other console that includes all the DLC on 360.
Oh, sure, PS3 gamers had to wait an extra year for the game, but I'm pretty sure if you gave the average gamer a choice between waiting an extra year and shelling out an additional $100, they'd probably... Fuck it, this is the same gaming community that shelled out happily an extra $200 for a Skyrim special edition because of a flimsy plastic statue and a burlap pillowcase with a map scrawled on top of it. If you need me, I'll be out in the clock tower with a high-powered sniper rifle, washing this den of iniquity clean with a righteous rain. I'm RazörFist, got fucking speed.